r/AskReddit by Reddicle. Cops of Reddit. A lot of people get jumpy and try to act normal around law enforcement. How can you tell genuinely suspicious people from self-conscious idiots acting weird? I knew a police helicopter pilot and I asked a similar question when searching for suspects. He said that the bad guys were the ones not looking up at the helicopter. Innocent people look. Point. Stare. Etc. I thought it was funny but true, to a point. I was taking the bins out one dark night and there was a police helicopter nearby. All of a sudden they lit me up with the spotlight. I was like a deer in the headlights. And after a second or two slowly waved at them, and then after a few more seconds the spotlight moved on elsewhere. It was so awkward, they must have been pissing themselves laughing. I had a similar thing happen to me when I was a RIMCA counselor. Police light shined on me and I frantically dabbed multiple times and made all the kids day. With that said, I still feel cringy for dabbing. However, I was happy to make those kids day. The police helicopter just flew right by and went to looking for whoever it was looking for. Pulled over for being lost in the wrong neighborhood. Was relieved as I did not have a GPS at the time. Horribly lost, was hoping the cop that had been tailing me for the last mile would pull me over to get directions. Wants to know why a white boy like me is in a neighborhood like this. I explain I'm lost. Doesn't believe me, says I'm here for drugs. My whole attitude changed because I'm suddenly nervous. Why would he think that and realizing this could go badly? He says only guilty people act nervous. He ends up calling a K-9 unit to search my car. Other cop is really cool. We chat and he apologized for first cop being a jerk. After search he gives me directions on how to get to my destination. Good cop, bad cop is real. Same happened to me before I ever hand him my ID. I was a white dude in a nice car in a black neighborhood. I said, excuse me, this neighborhood isn't bad. He said, yeah it is. I hand him my ID that stated I lived four houses down from where he stopped me. Never asked what I was doing. Just told me I was there to buy drugs. No officer, I live here. Douche. Opposite thing happened. We live in a nicer, predominantly white neighborhood and we were waiting for a black friend to come over. He finally showed up and said he had been pulled over by a cop who asked if he was lost. I got pulled over for speeding on Canada Day on my way up to Ottawa from Toronto. I did the usual routine of pulling over somewhere safe, taking the registration out and putting both hands on the wheel at 10 and 2. The cop approaches and I ask if it's okay for me to reach over and turn down the music, which I forgot to do. He starts laughing and says okay. He tells me to put my hands down since I'm making him nervous. I'm like, you're making me nervous. Back in Toronto I don't take any chances and the cops are usually appreciative. But they have never told me to relax. It's best to err on the side of caution with Toronto police. But the out of city cops are usually pretty laid back. We had a good old Canadian laugh, wished each other a happy Canada Day, and then he gave me a ticket for 115 and a 100. Sigh. Edit. I was caught going 125 kilometers per hour in a 100 kilometer per hour zone. The cop reduced it to 115 kilometers per hour. Ha ha, happy Canada Day, eh? Same to you, man. Oh, and sorry, here's your ticket for 115 and a 100. Oh, sorry. At least that's how I imagined it in my head. As a Canadian, I can honestly and seriously verify that this conversation has happened somewhere. The funny thing is, if I'm off duty and around a uniformed officer I don't know, different depth, area, etc., I get nervous. Hell, my heart sometimes skips a beat when I see one of our own cars driving down the road. Even though it may be the same exact vehicle I was assigned to just a few hours ago. My point is, I think pretty much everyone gets nervous around a cop. Most people will avoid you and not make eye contact. But what really stands out for me are the adults that will periodically look at you. Or you feel them staring at you like they're trying to ID your face. I've had to arrest a lot of people over the years. And many of them are back out on the streets. If I'm off duty and around a uniformed officer I don't know, different depth, area, etc., I get nervous. That right there says a lot. Now think about how the rest of us must feel. Acquisitive crime. I like that way of putting it. I'll be using that from now on. XD. By all means. but I'm afraid I can't take credit for it. It's the proper term over here. Your post reminds me of a funny piece of info. A good friend of mine works as a lawyer for one of the bigger insurance companies in defense. A good percent of accidents happen because people freak out about the mere presence of the cop and don't focus on the actual driving. Like literally during a deposition I didn't see them pull out. There was a cop on the same road. In medicine we have a similar phenomenon called white coat hypertension. Being in the mere presence of a doctor raised patients' blood pressures. So a patient may have a normal BP. But every time they step into the office to get it checked it goes up. Going to the doctor can be bad for your health sometimes. Went for a stress test once and the doctor told me he had a woman reach the required heart rate, 180 BPM if I recall, just from panic at being hooked up to all the sensors. She never even got off the bed and onto the treadmill. I'm one of those jumpy people. I've been pulled over and screamed at, "Why are you so nervous? What are you hiding?" And another time. The cop was very nice and just said, "Relax. It's just a ticket. Are you okay? Do you want to catch your breath? Not a big deal. Take a couple deep breaths." Buddy super friendly and helped me relax. I get anxiety in those situations without any real cause. I just get really nervous. It's crazy how differently cops can handle a situation in the exact same circumstances, just one was nicer or trained better. I've only had one bad instance with a cop who was convinced I was up to no good. He asked me what I was doing and I told him. He asked me why I took a specific exit before my destination and I mentioned I needed gas. He said, "Well, you've got an answer for everything, don't you?" "Yes, sir. It's not that difficult when it's the truth." He ended up having me wait outside the car for half an hour while he went over it with a canine unit after I refused to let him search. I didn't want to have to reorganize everything after he rummaged through it, I had nothing to hide. Then when the dog found nothing he searched the car anyway because I seemed nervous because I was sweating, after standing in the Texas sun in August for 30 minutes. I filed a complaint and was pretty much told, "Too bad, our officers are risking their lives for you every day and people shouldn't be questioning their authority." Well, that's some bullshit right there. There was no probable cause to search your car. Sweating doesn't equal probable cause to search. They need visual evidence. Consent to search, or if them or a canine unit smells drugs, which I personally don't like because how can they prove they smell it? They could just say they smell weed in order to search whatever they want. That situation was BS and I feel you had some legal rights infringed on. And feel like you cold legally done something about it. Cop here. I'll give a serious answer instead of all the others. Assuming this is on a traffic stop. For the most part. If you are acting jumpy, I try to figure out why and remove that stress. If I can't figure it out on my own, I'll just simply ask. Common answers are, "I don't like cops, I don't want a ticket," and so on. My reasoning for this is, if you're relaxed and I ask if there are any weapons in the car and your stress indicators skyrocket when you say no, something is wrong. If you're already stressed, I won't be able to see that reaction. As others have stated, it's not 100%. Some people are just nervous Nellies. I try to calm people down for their sanity and my safety, but it doesn't always work. Serious question. Are US cops trained to reach for the firearm if you leave the vehicle? I'm from England. And twice forgot myself and done as would be expected in England. And got out the car when pulled over. Both times the cops dropped a hand to the firearm. I can't speak for all US cops. Training carries quite a bit state to state and even agency to agency. It is very much out of the norm and last year there were several cops killed when people they pulled over stopped, got out, and started shooting. Dropping the hand to the gun is sort of an instinct, so your hand is where it needs to be while you make the decision to draw or not. Statistically, despite media hype, we shoot second not first and are often behind the bad guy by that much reaction time. Every little bit of speed in a shooting helps if you need it. Every time I get pulled over, as soon as my tag is run through the system, the police get on their bullhorn and tell me to get out and lay on the ground. Not because I'm black, because I'm a two-time convicted felon, been crime-free for 6 years, but I always find it amusing and after all the foolishness I always have a laugh with them. Javal FL. I have anxiety. Every time a copper pulls me over, I look guilty. But really I'm scared of unwarranted police violence and nervous about how much money today's ticket will cost me. Police always notice. And they always say that makes me suspicious. So they have reason to ask to search me and my possessions. I feel like I can't be the only innocent person in the world who gets the jumps around police. But they always act like I'm the first person they've ever encountered who acts guilty when I haven't actually done anything. Police instructor here. You look for what is out of place context. If everyone is looking at an event or certain direction and that one person is staring at you or in the completely opposite direction, that's the oddball. People draw attention to themselves by behavior that is different from the environment or expected of the environment that they are in. It's how they identified the Boston bombers. Everyone was looking in the direction of the explosion, but the brothers were staring in the opposite direction. Suspicious behavior. This technique can be applied to clothing as well. If it's summer and you see people wearing heavy jackets, there's something odd. Somebody keeps tapping the waistline and there's no reason for him to do that, like something falling off of it and there's something tucked in their waistline, drugs or weapons. Now, not saying that this gives you an excuse to go up and start harassing people, however it definitely lets you narrow down the focus of your attention for what is out of place. If it's summer and you see people wearing heavy jackets. What? Mr. Treacher? And today OP learned the value of the serious tag. Arts never learn. Not today. Not ever. To be fair, it would be easier to learn if search was even remotely close to 1995 Alta Vista. Search in Google for term plus Reddit gets infinitely better results. Cops once woke me up at 3 a.m. in the morning because my neighbor saw flashlights in woods next to my house. And then they started questioning me. Asking me why I seemed so nervous and if I wasn't doing anything. Why were there footprints in the snow in front of my duck-eyeing front door? I was a 19-year-old kid living on my own in a small town, so small it didn't have a population. I just remember being absolutely flabbergasted at why they would want to know why someone might be nervous from getting a visit from the cops in the middle of the night. And why they thought footprints in a heavily traveled area were suspicious. I basically told them some variation of that and then told them they were welcome to look around outside if they wanted before they left. This was during deer hunting season in Wisconsin. So the only thing I could think of is that maybe they thought there was some poaching going on. Still, it showed a remarkable detachment from reality that they couldn't understand why I was so nervous to begin with. I had a similar incident. Dead asleep. Woken by the police pounding on the door. This is before cell phone, so naturally, no eggs. Husband and I wake up and run downstairs. Cue the police shining a light in our faces and the first thing they said. Oh. Let me guess, you just woke up. How convenient. So X and I were like, oh, yeah we did. What's going on? Cops says our car was involved in a hit and run of several cars. A friend of ours was staying over a few nights. We motioned behind us to the couch where he was sleeping to the cops. Who come in? Dude is in his shoes yet and is sweating. So, yeah. Thanks for assuming, dudes. Actual police officer here. Verified in r/protect-and-serve. There really is no magic answer. There is a ton of overlap between both groups and anyone who says they can consistently spot the difference is lying to you. I'd rather judge the situation based on the objective facts rather than my gut feeling. Last time I was stopped. I had my windows down. Car off. Keys out of the ignition. ID and registration out by the time the cop came to my door. Is this more suspicious than just waiting for the cop to tell me what to do? Also, if it's nighttime, turn a light on inside the car. Shows the cops you're not hiding anything. Random story. So not long after I got my license, I was driving around and at a stoplight there was a cop behind me. I hadn't done anything wrong. Cops at that point didn't freak me out yet. And I even knew a kid in school who was planning to become one. The light turns green and I go. I notice behind me everyone is behind the cop on all lanes. It weirded me out. Usually there are cars passing me or next to me. People were giving the cop a nice wide berth or at least not wanting to drive ahead of it. It made me feel paranoid and I checked my speed. I was actually going slower than the speed limit, After I figured out everyone was just being paranoid, I sped up to the speed limit and that was that. The cop was driving slower than the speed limit and I drove off, leaving them all behind. I feel like the cop probably thought it was hilarious that his presence was slowing down traffic, cause it wasn't like he was trying to control it. His lights weren't on. Since then I've had plenty of speeding tickets. Plenty. Plenty. But not on that day. Cops freak me out now too. Ha. Every time I see one I go, oh shit. Speed limit? I'm okay. Car functioning right? Yes. Drugs in the car? Wait. I don't do drugs. It's a tense situation. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.